Hey guys, Helen Hartsmith here again from the Heart of the Witch's Path YouTube channel. Hope you're having a good day. I totally am. I'm coming to you live with an in-depth report. Are you ready for this? I have been doing some in-depth research to bring this video to you today. So I don't know about you guys, but I have many addictions. Let's be real about this. I kind of have developed recently a stone addiction. That's something that's for another video. But I also have a book addiction. I love books. And so I troll bookstores all the time. I love bookstores. I love the smell of them. I like new books. I like old books. I like books on all subject matter. And yeah, books. I love books. So I don't know if you've realized or noticed lately, but in my trolling of the metaphysical section, I've been noticing lately that there's been numerous books put out that are like, I'm gonna give you my own kind of description of it, and it's not meant to be derogatory or anything like that, but they're pretty books in the New Age section. These really pretty hardcover books that, you know, have foil in the cover and colored, and you know, they're very appealing to the eye. But I was like, okay, they're pretty, but what's the content? What, you know, are they just made to, you know, look cool and draw people in, and do they have like no content? So this video is kind of talking about that, and I bought one of these books, and so it's kind of a book review at the same time. And so if you stick to the end of this video, somebody will be quasi rewarded. How's that? So, let's see. The book that I purchased is this one. It's so pretty. Look at that. I love the size, first of all. Can I just tell you, I love the size. Here's the thickness of it. So this is The Good Witch's Guide, a modern day Wicca, not Wiki, Wiccapedia for magical ingredients and spells. And this is by Sean Robbins and Charity Bedell. It's a beautiful book, and I'll show you what the back looks like. I'm keeping the table of contents. So this book cover, I don't know what that foundation material, like what the purple is. I don't know exactly what that's called, but like I said, this is a hardcover book. This is a 2017 copyright, so it just came out. I believe it was like the tail end of last year. This book is over 300 pages. Once you go through the index, there's an index, you guys. Gotta love an index. So there's 306 pages, to be specific. And I bought this book to find out what's with the hype. You know, is it worthwhile? And I'm glad to say that, yeah, I think that it's worth it. So this book is retailing. I picked this up at, let's see, I think it was a Barnes and, no, it wasn't a Barnes and Noble, but Schuller's, that's what it was. So it's $14.95. So really doesn't cost any more than a lot of the soft cover books that we buy, and the pages are all like purple toned too. I mean, they just carried this look throughout the entire book. And so it's cute, super cute. There's little drawings, there's little pictures throughout, and things like that. So let's kind of talk about what's in the book and is it worth it? So there's some lovely author's notes. The two, I believe it's two women that wrote this book. They have some nice notes at the beginning of it. And then they kind of, they jump right in. There's not a whole lot of, you know, pussyfooting around. They go in. So the first section is titled, Ye Old Witches' Wisdom, Rituals, and Formulas. And so there's chapters in here on a magic garden, on aromatherapy, and on crystal power. So going through there, there's some really great lists of correspondence stuff between the stones and aromatherapy and things like that. I was very impressed by how much content there was, because that first section is about 90 pages. Oh, look it. Oh no, I opened to the second chapter. I think that's, yeah. So here's the first section. That's a good amount. And the type isn't super big. So they actually pack in a lot of good information on plants and stones and aromatherapy. I mean, this right here is great information in and of itself. But then you've got, you know, 200 more pages of awesomeness. So, there's blends here to use with aromatherapy, both like in a diffuser or making, you know, your own spray or oil to wear. So that's really cool. I mean, they've done a really good job of covering the bases, which I'm really impressed with, because some folks, you know, some books that I've looked at, they might just give you lists of stuff, but then don't give you any kind of practical means to use them. But there are ritual. There's a stone cleansing in here. There's information on stones and chakras and which ones work with which chakras, things like that. So there's even some aromatherapy stones and talking about making crystal essences. And so that's really cool. The only thing that I wish that they would have talked about, I'm trying to, it looks like all of these rocks can get wet, because one thing that you have to be aware of when doing crystal essences, which that is putting rocks directly into water and allowing water to take on the properties that you're intending, okay? And then you drink that water. That is what a water essence, or excuse me, what a stone essence is. It's a very basic definition of it. But there are some stones that you cannot get wet, or they are toxic to drink water that those stones have been in. And so I wish that they, maybe they did and I missed it, because I didn't read every single page here. I just kind of like went through. So ladies, if you happen to see this video and you do point that out, then let me know. I would love a correction, but I didn't see anything. But anyhow, good information in that first 90 pages alone. But then we jump into even better information. So part two is all about spirit spells and spirituality. So there's chapters that deal with spell casting, like recharging your mind, body, and spirit. So I like the fact that they're not just spells. They're talking about, you know, broadening your experience and about the spirituality that is Wicca and witchcraft and working magic. There's a whole chapter on healing candles, a sacred flame. So there's good information there on color correspondences. Some pretty hefty lists. It's not just a couple of things for red. There's a chunk. And so, you know, I found that information very useful to look through. There's a chapter on spiritual alchemy and holistic enlightenment. So that was really interesting to go through. And then part three is craft your own personal magic, talking about DIY brews and potions. So making teas, tisanes, and potions using, you know, your own plant matter and stuff like that. and recipes. That's some top-notch information right there. And then kitchen witchery or kitchen witchy ware. So there's actually some recipes in there and about cooking, you know, doing that whole kitchen witch thing that I think is really cool. And I kind of practice a little bit, but I don't do a lot of it. But there's even some recipes in there that go specifically for Sabbats and stuff like that. So that's really fun too, because I know as a coven that we try to plan our feasting so that we're eating foods that, you know, kind of have a special meaning for the Sabbath, or try to. And so sometimes you need to look at some examples to kind of spark your own creativity and say, oh, I can make something like this. I can make something like that. So that's kind of fun. One other thing that I thought was interesting in general about this book is that it looks like the ladies have taken some bits and pieces from other folks. Now, I was looking at, and they cite these people, like right there in the text. It's not a footnote or anything like that. You know, I'm trying to find one really quick here while I'm talking to you. I guess I should have marked something, right? Let's see. Oh, come on. Of course, I'm not going to find anything. Towards the back of the book, there were quite a few. But they cite things and I didn't really recognize any of the names. So I'm not sure if they are established authors or if they're blogger, like I don't know exactly who they are. So again, Sean and Charity, if either one of you see this, because there is a section in the back that talks about acknowledgments. So I have to say that this whole back section, there's a resources page that has some great sites on where you can purchase things. There's a recommended reading and reference material page. And so maybe some of those folks are who are being referenced in the text. Now I do recognize Raven Caldera's name. And his book, The Northern Shamanic Herbal, is recommended as a book to read. Oh, and there's some Scott Cunningham stuff, but I don't remember seeing anything cited inside. Oh, and there's Christopher Penzack. So I'm not entirely sure who they were citing. Oh, wait a minute. Who is this? Contributors. Okay, so it looks like these folks actually contributed to the making of this book. So that's cool. Okay. So that's probably why they might be kind of like regional folks that these two ladies know. Okay, so that's really cool. I might have to take a look at that and just kind of see who's who and stuff like that, because there's a little blurb on who people are and things like that. So yeah, so in general, and then of course there's an index. I always like me a good index. So let's talk about brooms. In terms of brooms, well, before I give brooms, let's talk about, I think this is almost like a perfect mini book of light for someone, especially if you're kind of new and are looking for, you know, information and looking for stuff to start compiling your own book of shadows, book of light, grimoire, whatever you'd like to call it. There are some, this is beautifully done. I love that there's a theme throughout the entire book. Not only, you know, you don't just have a pretty cover with, you know, purple, but that purple actually goes through the entire book. And so I appreciate that. There was definitely some thought that went into doing this. It's not just a pretty cover with no substance inside. This is a very well put together book in every way that I can see. Again, I'm a sucker for a cute small book. I love that. That is it'll sink me every single time and want to buy a book. So yeah, love that. Now let's talk about brooms. I long for, you know, good books like this. Not that they're not out there, but I long for good books. You know, sometimes when we buy books, we run the risk of, you know, kind of buying something that doesn't work well for us simply because, you know, whatever reason. But this, you know, was a blind buy. I didn't know anybody that had bought this. And this is a good book. This is a really good book. I'm going to give this book 5 brooms. It's got everything. It's well put together. It's pretty, which is a pleasing to the eye. And it's got great information. And it's well cited. So 5 brooms for sure. This is awesome. I don't think I've seen a book that covers this amount of stuff that's like ready to use in a while. I mean, there's some good books out there, but you might have to kind of pick and choose and like make your own list of things or something like that. But this is like ready to go. Like I said, this is like a mini Book of Shadows ready to go out the gate kind of a thing. So 5 brooms. So now let's get to the fun bit. Like this wasn't fun enough, right? I had, when I originally purchased this, I had purchased it with an intent because I had a milestone that was coming up on the channel. And so I thought, well, you know what? I'll buy this and let's pass on the goodness, shall we? So, I don't necessarily have a need for this particular book in my library at this time, even though it's really good. And hopefully I don't live to regret this or I'll just go out and buy another one. But anyhow, the channel has, we're up to 2,000 subscribers. And I just checked today and we were kind of hovering that last 100 subscribers was taking longer than, you know, you hope. Kind of a thing. And so I just looked at the numbers this morning and we were at 2,005 subscribers on the channel the day that I am recording this. And so that was what I was kind of saving this book for, to do a review. And then I'm going to pass this goodness on to somebody else. I'm going to do a giveaway with this book, and who knows if I, you know, if I'm smart enough and plan ahead enough, there might even be some extra goodies in the box. Who knows? But I am going to do a giveaway. And so let me say that this giveaway is for U.S. residents only. Here are the rules. You have to be a subscriber to this channel. So if you're not yet, go find it. You have to be a subscriber and you have to make a comment down below and tell me, let's see, what's the requirement? Tell me something fun about yourself and that you want to be included. Let's make this a time of sharing so that we can, you know, learn about each other. I tell you guys all kinds of personal stuff. So let me learn something about you. How's that? And so, yeah, so you have to subscribe to the channel. You have to leave a comment below telling me that you want to be in the drawing and something interesting about yourself. And I won't say you have to be a subscriber to my Instagram, but I mean, if you are, then that would be great. And that link is down in the description box. So how I'm going to work this is I'm going to give everybody 2 weeks. I am kind of a firm believer that I don't do a giveaway and put giveaway in my title. I kind of like my giveaways to be, I like it to be embedded in the video. And so you find out about it if you actually watch the video. Cause I know that there are some people out there that just kind of troll everything and they go for, they look for giveaways and then they go sign up for them. And I want this giveaway to be for the people that actually watch my videos and such. So that's why I don't, excuse me, I don't put, you know, giveaway or anything like that. So, yeah. So what's going to happen is when I post this video, I'm going to give, everybody it's 2 weeks, from the day that I post it, 2 weeks later, I will gather up all the names and I will do a drawing. Okay. So, I hope you're excited about this because I'm really excited to give it away. So if you liked this video or learned something from it, you know what to do. Give it a thumbs up. I just lost my train of thought. Totally. Give it a thumbs up. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to the channel. There's all kinds of fun links to find me in other locations in that description box. And if you're interested in purchasing this for yourself, I will also include a link in the description box to Amazon so that you can purchase it yourself. And while I'm talking about Amazon, I found out recently about a program called Amazon Smile. Amazon Smile is a thing that you can sign up for as a charity, and I think you get like cash back. So if you guys are Prime members, the Temple of Witchcraft is a charity under this Amazon Smile. Okay, so I encourage you to, if you don't have a charity that you're already giving donations to, look up the Temple of Witchcraft, and if you're so moved to do so, and make them your charity of choice. I don't know a lot about the program. The roomie holds the Amazon account in this house, so I haven't even like looked at what it was, but like I said, I found out about it recently, and I thought I'd throw it out there if anybody were motivated to do that, okay? So that's going to be it for this video. I'm going to stop rambling now. It was great checking out this awesome book. Great job, Sean and Charity. I really, really enjoyed it, and I hope that whoever wins this will enjoy it as well. Thanks for watching, and thanks for walking the path for a little while with me. Until next time, blessed be.